What's up? This is Darnell at YourOnline.biz. I want to continue my review of the best SEO plugin for WordPress. But before I get to that, I want to draw your attention to my latest article, which is an interview with Adrian Smith. So I want you to definitely check out this article, What I Learned from Adrian Smith. And I want to give a big shout out to Adrian. Thank you for taking the time to do this interview. I definitely learned a lot, and you will too if you check out this interview and find out what I learned from Adrian. All right, now, with that said, I want to jump back over to a new post that I've created. And just so you get a little bit, you know, just double dose of understanding of what this plugin can do for you. So, using the Yoast SEO plugin, I've went ahead and optimized this post. I filled in the fields. Okay, you can see my focus keyword is guest posting. And using the page analysis tab, which is the most detailed view for SEO by Yoast, it tells me, hey, you got the green light. So as far as it's concerned, it is optimized for SEO. Well, if you compare that to SEO Presser, it's rating me currently with a score of 7 out of 100. So that just gives you, again, that should just tell you right away, you know, the difference of how much you're leaving off the table. So let's just look at some of the recommendations. It's giving me keyword decoration. It's telling me I do not have my keyword in H3 tags, H1, H2 tags. I do not have my keyword underlined. It's not in italic, it's not in bold. So I can look at some of these recommendations. The link, I don't have a link pointing to an internal page. So it's giving me 3 different categories of recommendations, and it's just explaining to me exactly what I need to do. So if you're struggling with getting traffic, you need to get SEO Presser, because it's going to help you get traffic, which is search engine traffic that most people want to get anyway. So you can see how making these adjustments will increase my chances of getting found on the internet, and ultimately my score will improve. Now I'm going to stop the video right here, and I'll come back to this post after I have completed all of the recommendations, and hopefully I'll have increased my score to very close to 100%. Okay, as you can see, I'm back and I have a score of 93, and I just want to share with you really quickly what I did to increase that score. One of the things I like about the SEO Presser plugin is that you can use 3 keywords, where the SEO by Yoast plugin will only allow you to use 1 primary keyword. So, you know, that just gives you another idea of the difference between these 2 keywords. It's really, SEO Presser really is a much more mature tool, and gives you a lot more ways to really describe your content. That's really the way that I take these SEO plugins. They're really all about trying to explain more meta. That's why they say meta, you know, it's data about data. This is meta information about your post. What types of keywords? Well, SEO Presser is giving you 3 different types of keywords you can use. How did I come up with that? Well, whatever you do, you don't want to start keyword stuffing. So what I did was I just took my root word, which was guest, and I just searched for it to see what other types of words did I just naturally write. And so then I just added guest post and then guest post plural. So that was one of the things that I did to help get my score up. And then I also completed all of the suggestions from the plugin on all three tabs. It's got three tabs that it gives you suggestions to improve your SEO score. So keyword detection, I completed all of these recommendations, such as use your keyword in a heading tab. I'm sorry, heading tag. URL, which is suggestions like make sure your keyword is in the anchor text of an internal link. So you want to make sure you have some link somewhere with your with that keyword. And the third one is content, which has the most suggestions. You want to have your keyword in the first 100 words. You want to have your keyword in the last 100 words. And you know, you want to use one LSI keyword, which if I click over to this, it'll give me LSI keywords. So it's just telling me the types of keywords that I should you know, consider using in my post. So the result of that is a score of 93, and definitely I even feel that I have higher odds of my post getting found, as I've had to take some additional steps here to describe it and make sure that I was you know, basically promoting it, promoting the best aspects of the post. So that's why I recommend SEO Presser. I really think that you will, if you're serious about growing your online business, then I believe that you will be happy with this plugin. All right, now if you have any questions, let me know. Definitely check out my latest post, What I Learned from Adrian Smith. And if you have any questions, you can reach me on social media. Follow me on Twitter at FreedomMMC. And like this page on Facebook. I'd appreciate it. If this video helped you out, I appreciate that. And until the next time, peace.